हेलो, एम आई ऑडिबल? हेलो,
यस सर,
ओके, कैन यू सी द स्क्रीन?
यस सर,
वेरी गुड. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू परफॉर्म द शॉर्ट सर्किट टेस्ट ऑफ सिंगल फेज ट्रांसफॉर्मर. In our last experiment, we have studied the open circuit test, in which we have basically studied the core loss or the primary loss of a transformer. Now, in this test, we are going to study the copper loss or secondary loss of a transformer. Now, in this experiment, we are going to short circuit the secondary side of the single phase transformer and supply it the 240 volt 50 hertz AC supply to the primary side, and from our readings we are going to calculate the secondary side of the transformer. Now in the screen you can see the apparatus required for this experiment. Firstly, we do require AC wattmeter. Then we do require a variac, a transformer 1 kVA single phase 115 to 230 volt 50 hertz and other connecting wires. Along with that, we do require a AC voltmeter and a AC ammeter. Now, let's move to the table first. Here, write down this table. This will be your observation table. Here, all the readings we will take in the primary side. That means this voltmeter reading is the primary voltage reading. This ammeter reading is the primary current reading with full load condition. And this wattmeter reading is the power rating of the primary side. Write down the table. Let me know when you are done. Is it done? Have you written the table?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, before starting the experiment, let me tell you a little bit about what is the copper loss of a transformer. Basically, in the previous class, I have explained that a transformer naturally have two kind of losses. One appears in the primary side, that is due to hysteresis loss and eddy current loss, which is known as the core loss of the transformer. Now, in the secondary side, there appears another kind of loss, which is known as the copper loss of the transformer. Basically, this loss signifies a loss of energy. Now, all of us, we know that a transformer basically uses a good amount of copper wires to wound up both of the coils. Now, since copper is a conductor, though it will provide some amount of resistance while current will flow through it. So since we are building up the primary side and the secondary side of the transformer by using copper wires, that's why naturally it will provide us with some amount of resistance. And in addition with that, when we connect a load with the secondary side, that will also provide us with some resistance. Now, these resistance obviously will resist the flow of current through both of the coils. And due to that resistance, there will appear an amount of loss within the transformer, which in turn is known as the copper loss of the transformer. Now, the higher amount of turns, the higher amount of conductor used inside the transformer, the higher amount of copper loss that might appear within the transformer. Now, basically, you can understand that this kind of loss generally appears in the secondary side from where we are taking the output of the transformer. Now, in this experiment, the setup can be explained in an easy way that we are going to sort the terminals or the output terminals of the transformer, and then we will provide the input side or the primary side with a 230 volt 50 hertz AC supply, and then we will measure the input voltage, the primary current in full load condition, and the input energy. And from those three readings, we will calculate some things. Let's see the calculation part. Here, see if W is the wattmeter reading, V1 is the supply voltage at short circuit, that means in full load condition, and I1 is the full load current. Then high voltage side, that means the secondary side, here we will consider the low voltage side as the primary side and the high voltage side as the secondary side. Now, if these three are as denotation, then in the high voltage side, we can calculate the impedance as Z1. Z1 will be Z1 equals to V1 by I1. Then the equivalent resistance referred to the high voltage, that means the secondary side, is R1 equal to W by I1 square. It is known to us that W, that means wattage, equals to R1 I1 square. Now, from that equation, we can derive R1 equals to W by I1 square. Now, V1, I1, and W, all three will be taken from our readings. From there, we will calculate Z1 and R1. And after calculating Z1 and R1 for the HV, that means the secondary side, then we will calculate the equivalent reactance referred to primary side. That will be X1. And that is equals to Z1's root under Z1 square minus R1 square. I think you should write down these equations. Because when we will perform the experiment, then parallelly you can solve these equations if you have written that. Okay, so please write down these equations. Firstly, write W is the wattmeter reading, V1 is the supply voltage, and I1 is the full load current. First, write these three things. Then write these two equations, that means Z1 equals to V1 by I1 and R1 equals to W by I1 square. We refer to the primary side, X1 equals to root under Z1 square minus R1 square. There's a third equation. Let's move to the next segment. From the short circuit test data, turn ratio, that means the turn ratio of the transformer under our experiment, is N1 by N2, that equals to E1 by E2. Consider this N1 by N2 as 0.25. Here, see here, this is the turn ratio. 115 by 230. What is the value of 115 by 230? Calculate. What is it?
Sir, 0.5.
0.5. That is your turns ratio. Okay? So, now from that turn ratio, we will develop another two things. Firstly, the equivalent resistance, that means equivalent resistance of the transformer winding referred to the secondary. That are equivalent. This is the resistance or equivalent resistance of the secondary side. That is N1 by N2 square. That means this one, turn ratio 0.5 square into R1. R1 have been calculated from here, W by I1 square. Now put that value here. So you will get the equivalent resistance of the secondary side. Clear? Am I clear? If it is confusing, let me know. I will explain it again. Is it clear to all of you? Now let's move to the next one. Equivalent reactance of the transformer winding referred to the secondary. So here in these two equations, firstly we are calculating the equivalent resistance and then we are calculating the equivalent reactance of the secondary side. The secondary side reactance X equivalent equals to 0.5 square, that means N1 by N2 square, into X1. X1 is being calculated from here. X1 equals to root under Z1 square minus R1 square. So this is the calculation part of this experiment. You have to take the reading of these three, W, V1 and I1. Then by calculation, you have to find out Z1, then R1, then X1, then N1 by N2, then R equivalent for secondary, and X equivalent for secondary. This is your equivalent secondary side circuit. Sorry, this is equivalent primary side circuit. And this is the total circuit. You have to put the values here, R equivalent, here X equivalent, these two. Okay, clear? This this entire data sheet will be uploaded to your Google Classroom. Any question? So let us proceed to the experiment.
Students, to perform this experiment, we need some instrument here, okay? So this one is variac. This one is variac. It is an auto transformer. It has two terminal. One is common, another is phase. We give it 220 volt AC, 50 hertz AC, but we get output voltage from 0 to 70 volt. Okay. This one is voltmeter. Voltmeter has three terminal, one common, and another will be either 15 volt or 30 volt. Okay. We see one ammeter. This one is ammeter. This ammeter has three terminal, but we take out of three, we take two. Okay. Common is in a must. Okay. And I take either 5 ampere or 10 ampere. We take only one. Okay. This one is wattmeter. Wattmeter has four terminal, M, L, and C, and B. Okay. B. So M and L is internally connected by a coil. This coil is called current coil. And C and B also internally connected by a coil. This coil is called pressure coil. This one is internally connected. Okay. And this M and L is also internally connected by a coil. This coil is current coil. And C and B is called pressure coil. Okay. It's internally connected. But here in this instrument, M and C is open. Okay. So we sort by wire M and C. Okay. So for short circuit test, it is conducted at rated current. Okay. So for this transformer, this one is same transformer before we perform open circuit test. This one is 1 kVA, 50 hertz AC transformer. Primary voltage is 115 volt and secondary voltage is 230 volt. Okay. So for short circuit test, as it is conducted at rated current, so secondary side will be connected to the supply side. Okay. And high voltage side will be connected to one ammeter. Okay. This one is ammeter. This ammeter is connected to the secondary side. Okay. So what is the value of the rated current for this transformer? For different transformer, rated current is different. Okay. So for this transformer, so we have to find out the rated current. Okay. Value of the rated current. Okay. So we know that P is equal to VI cos phi. Okay. So cos phi is for resistive load, cos phi is 1. So P is equal to V into I. Okay. So I is equal to P by V. Okay. So for this, what is the value of this P for this transformer? This one is 1 kVA transformer. So value of the P is equal to 1 kVA. Okay. And V, value of the V is 230 volt. Value of the V is 230 volt. Okay. So I is equal to P by V. That is equal to 1 kVA by 230. That is 1 kVA means 1000 VA. That is 1000 VA divided by 230. This will be 4.33 ampere. Okay. So for this transformer, rated current is 4.33 ampere. So we'll take only one reading at primary current, 4.33 ampere. Okay. So what is the circuit connection? So here we see one voltmeter. Voltmeter is always connected in parallel. Parallel connection means two terminals will be connected to different two terminals. So this one is common. So common is connected to this one. So this one is common and this one is phase. So common is connected to the one terminal of the voltmeter. Another terminal phase. This one is connected to the another terminal of the variac. So these two different terminals is connected to the different two terminals of the variac. Now this connection is parallel connection. Okay. Next, ammeter is in series. So voltmeter common is connected to the ammeter common. So this one is input and its output, 5 ampere output. Output is connected to the M of the wattmeter. Okay, M of the wattmeter. Okay, M of the wattmeter. Okay, and MC is sorted. MC is sorted. So we sort M and C by a wire, okay. And for short circuit, as it is conducted rated current, so high voltage side will be connected to the supply side. So this high voltage two terminal, one terminal will be connected to the AL of the wattmeter. Okay, and another terminal will be connected to the B of the wattmeter. That is, V means 125 terminal, okay, 125 volt terminal, okay. And this 125 volt meter terminal will be connected to the 15 volt terminal phase, okay. And secondary side, one ammeter will be connected, okay. So one terminal will be connected to the common, one low voltage side, one terminal will be connected to the common, and another terminal will be connected to the 10 ampere, okay. 10 ampere, okay. So circuit connection is completed. Okay. Here you see that for different wattmeter, there is a multiplying factor, okay. And multiplying factor is written in the instrument, okay. So in this instrument, this wattmeter, there is a nameplate. Here written multiplying factor, okay. This one is multiplying factor table. Okay, here we select 125 volt, okay, and 5 ampere, okay. So 2.5 ampere equivalent to 5 ampere, and 5 ampere equivalent to 10 ampere for this wattmeter, okay. So so here in this case, we take 5 ampere terminal and 125 volt terminal. So multiplying factor will be 0.5, okay. So what reading we get from this wattmeter, it will be multiplied by 0.5. Okay. Okay, students. Any question regarding the circuit connection? Hello. So for short circuit test, we conducted short circuit test to find out the copper loss. Okay, so how to find out the copper loss? So copper loss is equal to wattmeter reading into 0.5. Okay. So any question regarding this circuit connection or anything else? Hello, students. Give response. Hello. So now we'll take reading, okay. So here we connect 5 ampere, okay. So we take lower reading, okay. So 4.33 will be between 4 and 4.5, okay. So 4 and 4.5 difference is 0.5 and division is 10, okay. So 0.5 divided by 10 means 0.05. So one division is 0.05, okay. So 4.33 will be 7 and 8 division, okay. Between 7 and 8 division. So increase the voltage slowly. Okay, so if you note down this ammeter reading, 4.33. If you note down this one, next, primary voltage is, we connect 15 volt, okay. So it will take lower reading, okay. So this will be 14.6. So everybody note down this reading, voltmeter reading, 14.6. Next, wattmeter reading. Here, wattmeter reading is stand at one division. That means difference is, one division is equal to, difference is 50. 100 and 150, difference is 50, and division is 5, okay? So, one division is 10, okay? So, now, this reading is 110, okay? 110, and multiplying factor is 0.5, okay? So, 110 into 0.5, what will be the value?
55,
okay? So, what minute reading is 55. So, copper loss is 55 watt, okay? And this one is secondary current is 8 ampere. Here we can 10 ampere, so take upper reading, this one is 8.1 ampere, okay? So students, any question regarding this experiment?
We have three readings of V, I and W, right? Now, I have shown you the calculations from those equations, put these values or use these values of voltage, current and wattage, and from there calculate the value of R equivalent and X equivalent, up to R equivalent and X equivalent for the secondary side. Is it clear? Hello, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so calculate these values from your experimental data by the help of those equations. The manual will be uploaded in your Google Classroom, and you have to submit your copy within before next Tuesday. Okay, now we will take your attendance. Sir will call your roll number and name. Response, give the response.
Roll number one.
Yes, sir.
Two.
Present, sir.
Three.
Present, sir.
Four.
Present, sir.
Five.
Present, sir.
Six. Roll number six. Seven.
Present, sir.
Eight.
Present, sir.
Sir, roll number six is also present.
Six is present, okay. Roll number nine. Ten.
Present, sir.
11.
Roll number absent. 11. Absent.
12.
Present, sir.
13.
Present, sir.
14.
Present, sir. Roll number 9 present.
Roll number 9 present. Okay.
Roll number 14 present, sir.
14 present. 15. Roll number 15.
Present, sir.
16.
Present, sir.
Sir, 15 present.
15 present, okay. 17.
Present, sir.
18.
Present, sir.
19.
Present, sir.
20.
Present, sir.
21. Roll number 21. 22.
Present, sir.
23.
Present, sir.
24. 25.
Present, sir.
26. 27.
Present, sir.
28. 29.
Present, sir.
30.
Present, sir.
31.
Present, sir.
32.
Present, sir.
I am calling your absence, okay? Roll number 21 is absent. Roll number 21 is absent today. 24 absent today. And 28 absent. Okay, thank you everybody. Today end our lab.